And now we will learn how to manage bounced checks from customers. If you are dealing with a bounced check from a customer, then three things must have happened. One, a customer paid a past invoice by check. Two, the check bounced after you deposited the check. And three, the bank charges you a fee for your customer's check that bounced. So, what changes in our QuickBooks records when a customer bounces a check? Well, the bank account balance has decreased by the amount of the check that bounced. Secondly, the bank account balance has also been reduced by the fee that the bank charges us for the customer's bounced check. And thirdly, the customer's invoice that the check was applied to is now again unpaid because they never really paid it if they gave us a bad check for that invoice. So what must we do if a customer bounces a check? Well, first, we have to decrease the bank balance by the amount of the check and by the amount of the fee that the bank charged us. Secondly, we have to mark the invoice that the check was applied to as unpaid. And thirdly, we have to charge the customer a fee, which is basically creating an invoice, but this invoice will specifically be for our time and effort regarding the bounced check. Usually, this fee that we charge the customer is more than the fee that the bank charged us. We can do all three of those things in less than a minute by using the bounced check tool. The bounced check tool requires that you find the transaction where you recorded receiving the bad check. The easiest way to do that is to open the deposit detail report. That's because the bank gives you information about the check that can be easily found with this report. After you open the deposit detail, you have to find the payment where the customer bounced the check. Inside that payment window is the bounce check tool. The bounce check tool is in the ribbon of the receive payment window. It's in the main tab, it's all the way to the right, and it says record bounce check. When you click that button in the right side of the main ribbon, this window opens up, Manage Bounce Check. And this is the Bounce Check tool, and it is very, very easy to use. When this window opens, all you have to do is put four simple pieces of information. First, you have to put the bank fee. This is what the bank charged us, because a customer bounced one of the checks that we deposited into the bank. Then we have to decide which expense account we will record this fee. This is the general ledger account that records the expense for the fees for the bounced check. In this case, QuickBooks created and added this account automatically to our chart of accounts. So the first time you use this tool, QuickBooks will automatically add this account spelled this way, and the type will be expense. Of course, you could click the pull down arrow and choose one of the other expenses from your chart of accounts. But in our example, we will leave this selected and we will use the account that QuickBooks created to record the expense of the bank fee for the bounced check. In this field, we put the date that the bank decreased our account for the bounced check and the fee. This is the day that the bank found out that the check was bad. Down here, we record the fee amount that we are actually charging the customer. Managing the bounce check is a service that we provide to the customer that takes extra time, energy, and attention. Therefore, we are entitled to charge them a fee, and we put the money amount of that fee in this box. Because that's income, QuickBooks automatically creates an income account the first time we use this tool. That income account will record all of the fees that we put in this box to charge the customer for the bounced check. For example, on March 28th, Holden got a notice from the bank that Candy's check, number 1234, that was deposited on March 22nd, bounced. The best way to find this payment, based on the information the bank told us, is in our report called the deposit detail. We open the deposit detail and we scroll down to the March 22nd deposit. Here is the March 22nd deposit, and here are the individual items that were deposited on March 22nd. Notice a payment from Candy with check number 1234 was deposited as part of that deposit. When we double-click, we can see that that payment was applied to invoice number 8. That means invoice number 8 is no longer paid and should now be marked as unpaid. So how do we fix this? Luckily, in the top right, we can click Record Bounce Check. Now, the date that the bank actually reduced our account was March 28. So that's the date we put in this box. The amount that the bank charged us was $20 in this example. Now, this $20 is going to be recorded into this expense account, Bank Service Charge. This is an account that QuickBooks automatically put in our chart of accounts when we opened this bounce check window. If we click the pull-down arrow, we have the opportunity to choose one of the other expenses in our chart of accounts to record this fee. But in this example, let's leave the one that the bank created for this fee. Now, we are going to charge the customers $35 for the service of managing their bounce check and for our time, energy, and attention. This $35 is income to us, and notice it's more than the bank charges us, which is customary. Don't worry about the income account regarding this fee. QuickBooks automatically created it, and you will see it as soon as we record this bounce check. When we click Next, we get a confirmation window that tells us all the information about what we just put in. So it tells us the invoice that will be marked unpaid. It tells us the check number that we know is a bounce check. It tells us the service fee so that we can know in advance how much our bank account will be reduced by. And it confirms the income amount for the fee that we're charging Candy for the bounce check. When we click Finish, we see at this payments window, this payment is now marked with the symbol bounced check. So here's the big question. Did we fix our QuickBooks records? Well, if we did, the bank balance would be decreased by the amount of the check and the amount of the fee. We can check this by opening the trial balance and double-clicking the number next to cash in bank. We can see that the cash in bank account has been decreased by the amount of the check and the amount of the fee. If we make the memo column a little bit wider, we can see that this reduction of $22.40 is from bounce check number 1234, and this reduction for $20 is for the service charge. So that's one problem solved. We also have to make sure that the invoice that the check was applied to is now marked as unpaid. We can do that by looking at the open invoice report and scrolling to the bottom section and looking at Candy. Notice here is invoice number 8 for $2,240 back on the open invoice report, which shows that this invoice is marked as unpaid. And finally, the customer was charged a fee for our time and effort regarding the bounced check. Well, if we again look at open invoice, in the very bottom section of open invoice where Candy's information resides, we can see that there is an invoice added to the open invoice report for $35. And when we double click and open it up, we can see that this invoice was specifically for the bounced check charge. You should also notice on the trial balance that there are two additional accounts that were not there before we recorded the bounced check. Bank service charges for $20 is the expense that records all of the bank fees specifically from customers' bounced checks. Return check charges is the name of the income account that QuickBooks added to the chart of accounts to record the fee that we charge the customer for the service of managing their bounced checks.